Amma, internet is not coming. Amma, internet is not coming. That, ladies and gentlemen, was my 5-year-old daughter. Every single month, around the 15th. Because invariably, I end up forgetting to pay the ACT internet bill. That is not the only instance. Picture this. I am in a client meeting and my wife calls me. She says, hey, there are these gentlemen from the electricity board and they want to pull out the fuse. Have you not paid the bill? I'm like, I just paid yesterday, but I think it was for last month. I will quickly pay it. Ladies and gentlemen, how many of you here have had this problem of procrastination? Raise of hands. Looks like everybody has the disease, but I have a master's and I have a PhD in the subject. Because these were not the only two instances. I have had hundreds. Let me list out a few more. What about income tax filing? When do you file your return, sir?
1st July.
1st of July, wonderful. Pretty much everybody else files it around April, May, June, July. But I? No chance. I wait until the last day, which is not July 30th. The extended last day, which is September 30th, to file my income tax returns. What about railway reservations? IRCTC opens up the reservation 6 months in advance. Thousands of seats. But no. I wait for the last day when the Tatkal premium opens. And I fight with millions of others for those 10 seats. And by chance, if I get it, then only my family gets to go on a trip. And at Infosys or anywhere else, when you have performance appraisals, your HR sends out emails probably 3 months in advance. Our HR, I'm sure I saw Toastmaster Ram case on that here. Our HR sends out emails 3 months before and they keep bombarding us day after day after day with reminders. I count, he counts, she counts, everybody counts. But then the count of the appraisals in my inbox just keep going up. And I have about 40 appraisals to close on the last day before midnight. Ladies and gentlemen, procrastination has been my biggest bane in my life. It has significantly deteriorated the quality of my life. This is not the only bad habit which I've had problems with. The second bad habit, which is saying yes when I want to say no. Picture this, last year during my wife's birthday, no less, we had planned for cake cutting at 7 in the evening. Everything was ready. The cake, my wife, all relatives. And then I get a call from the delivery manager. Hey Ram, there is a client call. I want you to join right now. In my mind, I was going, no way, dude. But then outwardly, I was like, yeah, of course. I will attend the client call. And I turn to my wife and I say, sorry, I need 30 minutes to attend this call. So yet again, priorities, lack of priorities is something that kind of hurt me in my life. The third bad habit that I have is giving up way too easily. Many of us, when we start a task, we try and stick to it at least a little bit, but not me. The first hurdle that comes up, imagine me to be a sports person running a 400 meters hurdles race, and you have hurdles every 40 meters. I come to the first hurdle, and I'm like, oh no, obstacles, I'm going back. Life is not one that way, ladies and gentlemen. You need to be hustling. You need to give it a good shot for you to be able to reach the winning side or reach the finishing post. So ladies and gentlemen, as I conclude, I want to tell each and every one of you, bad habits are like wisdom teeth. Every one of us has it. None of us want it. Because they serve no true purpose. And the longer you let them simmer under the surface, they are only going to grow deeper roots and they are going to become a pain that is going to be harder to get rid of later in life. So today, ladies and gentlemen, when you have the chance, get rid of those bad habits. I did when I had the chance. And I urge each and every one of you today, when you go back home, to look at what bad habits you have and try and get rid of them. Nip them in the bud or live with them and suffer the consequences. The choice, ladies and gentlemen, is entirely yours. Over to you, Mr.